Hello, my name is Elin Ranestål, and I'm one of the hosts here at Konstmuseet I Norr, and I would like to welcome you to our virtual guided tour of the exhibition En vacker utställning.
Hello, my name is David Svalbard. I'm a guide here in Konstmuseet I Norr. Today we're going to give you a virtual guided tour to our exhibition. And the exhibition we have now is called A Beautiful Exhibition, and it will show us a little bit what we call pretty and ugly in society, and how both of them need each other to survive. We need the ugliness to accept what's beautiful, and we need the beautiful to accept what's ugly, and so on. That's how it goes. And the artwork that we have is made by 12 artists from 3 different countries, from Norway, Finland, and Sweden.
We are now on the second floor where the exhibition starts. And in this room, we have some works by the artist and designer Lotta Lampa. She is originally from Kalix, and she takes a lot of inspiration from cruising culture, or raggarkulturen. And this is a culture that is very significant in Sweden, especially in smaller towns and on the countryside. But it has an aesthetic that I think most people are familiar with. And what Lotta Lampa does is she takes elements of this culture and she mixes them up and puts them in unexpected settings, and it gives a quite fun and exciting result. In this work called Burns Out, you can see how Lotta takes elements from cruising culture. She uses this flames aesthetic that you can see on vintage cars, for example, and she puts it on a park bench, which is a quite symbolic space when you think about it, because it's that sort of space that maybe teenagers go to hang out when there aren't that much else to do in the town. So it's a place that has a lot of associations and memories for people.
These works are also quite typical of Lotta Lampa. They are very simple in shape and expression, but then taking the title of the work, which is Fulans, and it translates to ugly dance, which is a type of dance that you do when you feel relaxed at home or at your local pub. And it sort of gives you a hint on a way to read the work. And to me, all of a sudden, these basic and rigid shapes become people on a dance floor that maybe had a few too many, I don't know, and can't really stand straight. And someone is on the floor doing a sort of breakdance move. And the artworks really come to life in a quite funny and exciting way. So Lotta Lampa's work really questions the gallery space and asks us which expressions are expected and accepted there, and in contrast, which expressions aren't. And it sort of gives us a chance to also come close to our own preconceptions and prejudice about art, but also culture and people in general.
These works are made by an artist called Erling Rensfeldt, and they depict one of the most common motifs throughout all of art history, which is the naked female body. But traditionally, the female nude has been used to portray other things, whether it's a Roman goddess or an ideal such as virtue or youth. But these women are quite different from what we're used to seeing. They seem to be at home, and rather than being naked, they are more undressed. And a lot of them are also cropped in a way that makes us feel like we are looking at them from somewhere hidden. Maybe it's a keyhole, and it puts us as viewers in a quite uncomfortable position, because you can feel like you're doing something that you're not allowed to do, and you can feel quite dirty and uncomfortable doing that. This wallpaper is made by the Sami artist Monika L. Edmondson. And from afar, it feels like a sort of warm and homely type of wallpaper that reminds you a little of traditional embroidery, but once you look at it in detail, you can see that it's in fact syringes and pillboxes, and it almost makes you want to take a step back because it's quite the opposite of something warm and homely. It has to do with disease and death. And Edmondson took photographs of these syringes and pillboxes as a part of the treating of her daughter that was sick in cancer. And then she puts them in this kind of order and pattern, and it really reflects on the everyday life when taking care of someone with a serious illness, because a lot of it has to do with a routine of medication and treatments. But it also reflects that on the inside you can feel disharmony and chaos, but on the outside there's a routine about it. She calls this work Malign Closure, as it is a sort of contemplation and meditation on this period of her life that she has now come to closure with.
And as to the colors and the patterns of the artwork, you can notice that it's really beautifully made. And she got inspired by her daughter got a present from her grandma with this sunny belt. And it looks, the patterns and the color is exactly the same. So she kind of got inspired, and she combined her daughter's disease with this beautiful Sami culture, and she kind of smashed it together and made this artwork.
We are now on the third floor, and I'm standing in front of these photographs by the Norwegian artist Morten Torjesrud. And they depict these lumps of clay that can be seen as a comment on the very typical motif of landscape painting. Because when you think about it, these lumps of clay are the smallest elements in what makes out an entire landscape. And they are specific for that place and that geography. They can also be seen as the starting point of so much pottery and sculpture and also buildings. And when you look at them, your brain sort of tried to decipher them and see what it is, and you can see faces and animals. But of course, if you ask a group of children, they will always tell you that it's poop.
And here we have Heli Reinene. She's a Finnish artist. She was born in Lisslami, Finland, and now she works and lives in her artwork is called Slow Motion, and it is this beautiful masterpiece of the 19th in the swing. And it's very noticeable with its method age, and you can see his skin is getting wrinkly. And that he somehow looks very sad in a way. But the cool thing about him is that he's sitting in a swing, which shows that this man is carefree. And the inspiration behind this artwork is, for us, when we get older, everything changes. For our body, to our mind, everything completely changes. But it's very hard for us to grasp that we're getting older. So we usually forget to enjoy the present moment. And we just think about the regrets that we have. Or it's usually, we think only about the past. But he's trying to show us to slow down and just enjoy the present day at its fullest. And here we have artwork by Erika Spekke. She's originally from Kiruna, but now she lives and works in Oslo, Norway. And her artwork is called Fukt, Tukt, Svett og Fett. Kind of catchy and nice name, I think. And one day she went to the swimming hall, and she saw all the women with different body types doing a lot of different activities, like swimming, and taking a shower, going to the sauna. And she saw this, and she kind of got inspired, so how our body is very different and very unique. Like, not how we see it, how models have their bodies. We have this only one type of body, right? But in reality, women have different body shape. So she decided to make this artwork, but at the same time, she doesn't want people to think only about her inspiration. She wants it to be open for our creativity as well. So we can look at it and maybe I can interpret it in my own way. It doesn't have necessarily to be about the female body.
These paintings are made by the Finnish artist Heikki Marila, and they also depict a very common motif in art history, which is flowers and the bouquet of flowers. Traditionally, this motif has been used to portray mortality and the futility of life, and it typically shows different stages of a flower, when it's blossoming and then withering and eventually decaying. What Marila does is that he takes this motif and he brings up the quite violent and almost disgusting parts of death and decay. When you look at the paintings from afar, you can really see the lines and the colors and the contours of the flowers, but when you come closer, these tend to blur out, and you can see the very heavy brush strokes and how Marila sometimes uses his hands putting the paint onto the canvas. And it really enhances this feeling of violence and brutality when it comes to death, and this very natural and organic part of death and decay that can make you feel a bit uncomfortable and disgusted almost. Now I'm standing in front of these sculptures made by the artist Irja Bodén, who is originally from Kiruna, but now lives and works in New York. And she works mainly with these kind of abstract-looking sculptures, where she takes functional ceramics and these kind of commercially-looking ceramic sculptures, and she mixes them with very handmade-looking and almost organically-shaped sculpture, and to create these kind of very special and humoristic sculpture that we see here. And she takes inspiration from her father's trophy case. He was a competitive shooter, and she has sort of played with the idea of how a trophy or an award could look like, taking these shapes and forms and stacking them on top of each other and arranging them in this way. And they are probably one of my personal favorites because you always find something new in them, and they never cease to surprise you with their hidden details and oddities everywhere.
And here we have other artwork made by Irja Bodén. They're called Pretty Please 1 and Pretty Please 2. They are hand-built dogs, and after she made them by hand, she used another alternative technique of fire smoking. And it's a technique traditionally used by Native Americans and other First Nations.
We're now standing in front of this work made by the two artists Gerd Aurell and Helena Laukkanen, and they have taken this very everyday object that is industrial paper that you usually use to just wipe surfaces with, but they have created something quite unique and spectacular with it by shaping it and painting it with ink and then stapling it directly to the wall. And they have been inspired by their stay in Kiruna, which you can see from the motifs that are places in the town, and it really ties in with the setting that you see here on the fifth floor. When we look out of the window, we see the town of Kiruna and the mines, and also the clock tower that has been moved from the old town hall. And this work, since it's made out of paper and so frail, it's not possible to keep it once the exhibition ends. And a lot of visitors think that's a quite sad fact, but that's also the point of it. It's to bring out the sense that things aren't made forever. Things will eventually disappear. And also, looking at the clock tower, it reminds us that even buildings and things that are made with bricks and stones, they won't last forever either, which the town renewal of Kiruna is an example of. This work is by the Finnish artist J.A. Juvani, that we can see looking back at us here on the screen. And the artist is wearing a beard, which is the sort of facial hair that is traditionally associated with masculinity and the male gender. But they are also wearing pink makeup and pink flowers, which is something in a Western tradition that is considered as feminine. And this ties in with the story that the artist is telling us through the text that is scrolling at the bottom. And it's about the artist's own experiences in growing up in a culture and a society where you don't feel like you fit into any of the ascribed gender roles and norms, and how you as an individual are reprimanded or punished or in other ways made to fit into those molds that exist. And since the artist is looking back at us, it makes us remember that we are also contributing to this culture and reproducing these norms and standards. And it gives us a very personal and honest point of view from the artist. In this room, there are several works by the artists Roger Mesto and Lucas Jatman, a couple of smaller drawings, and these large oil paintings in a work called The Great Runaway. And they are made with Roger Mesto's landscape paintings at the bottom, and then Lucas Jatman's text that he has done in a font that he has designed himself. And the landscapes depict this region, so locals and people familiar with the region will probably recognize it. But these bold and bright colors sort of takes it into a space that is between reality and dream or fantasy. And it can really take you as a spectator on a journey in both space and time and in memory. And that is something that you can really tell when we do guided tours here at the museum, because every visitor has their own view or opinion on what it is they see and discover through the paintings, and they differ completely from what another visitor sees, which is really exciting to hear when you're here.
Thank you for being on our virtual guided tour. Hope to see you guys soon. Stay safe and take care of yourself.